What's going on, world? AJ here. Today on our show, we're quarantined again. We're just going to do quarantine editions here, and we're just going to kind of talk shop right now here. So grab yourself a cup of coffee this morning, and let's get the show on the roll. I'm looking at doing live stream here probably. I need to get a good formula set up for it. I like to do a live stream and just schedule it, do one once a week during this time, and just see how it goes. Right now, I'm just going to video record, pre-record stuff, and go from there. But let's get the show on the road. I just kind of want to just touch base and just kind of update on some things. Quarantine life is going. I got the quarantine beard going on, you know. Man, I posted a little pic right there of my quarantine beard Friday on the, what is that thing called? Storyboard? Is that what it is on Facebook? I rarely use the story thing on Facebook or even on Instagram. I don't think I've ever done it on Instagram. I think I've done it on Facebook a couple times. And I'm like, what is the point of this? And then, of course, when I look at it and see how many people viewed it, it's like, oh my gosh, a lot of people actually look at these things. I didn't think anybody looks at these things. So I'm learning a little bit more about the social media world here. So kind of touch base a few things. Let's talk about rlcsedalia.com, our church website. Of course, you know, I operate and run that media side stuff for our church. And we got our blogs up and rolling. Man, we got some good blog pieces up. And we've been kind of lacking this week a little bit, but we're going to definitely get another one up for tomorrow on Monday. We'll get one posted there. My wife did the last one because I asked her to do one because I'm racking my brain over here. It's like, we need to keep this going. It's like, I need some contributions. So I may ask a couple people, hey, can you submit a blog piece? You know, keep it short and brief if you want. I don't have to be a long and elaborate, but just keep it simple. So I'm going to be asking a few of you guys out there in our church, just, you know, hey, I'm going to call upon you. If you want to submit a piece, you know, send it to me and I'll get it posted, and I'll take a look at it and we'll get it posted. All right, so that's kind of what we'll do from there. Just kind of get some new content, get some people, just, you know, contribute, you know, be a team player kind of thing, you know, add some stuff to our stuff here. We still got Facebook Live rolling on Sunday mornings. We're gonna be switching gears to using Zoom for our pastor, and I'm excited about that. I've used Zoom at work all the time and I'm familiar with Zoom. I've seen a lot of churches use it for their discipleships and meetings, and our district actually has done two meetings with it, which I think is incredible. I wasn't at their last one because it was Friday night, and I was like, I just want to hang out and watch a movie. We're talking about church finances anyway, so I'm like, that's not my area. I'll let Logan watch that one. So I was like, I'll let him sit in on that one. I don't need to be there for that. And, you know, they were calling all church pastors anyway. I assume senior pastors, but I'm sure I could have just popped on and listened in. You know, I don't really have anything to add to that side of stuff, but just probably educate myself on what you guys are doing, all right? But I attended their very first one, and I was like, man, this is awesome. Just I stayed silent through it because I was like, I'm just going to sit back and spectate and watch and learn and listen to people, see what's going on there. And so I'll be popping a few more, you know, here and there, just kind of checking it out. Live stream wise, of course, man, I'm just watching everybody's live streams and seeing what they're doing. There's do's and don'ts of live stream. And I really encourage everybody, all the pastors, all the church leaders, especially media team, go check out Phil Cook. PhilCook.com is a great resource for you. Go watch his videos on YouTube. He's been doing media for years and years and years, and he's an expert on that stuff. If you want some advice, some tips, check out some of his stuff. He's been really hot and heavy right now because we're all live streaming, and so he's really contributing more and more on this stuff, giving you free resources and tips on how to better yourselves with the limited supplies that we got on the media front. So he's really great resource. PhilCook.com is where you want to go. And I encourage every pastor, every leader to go check that out. Please, please check out PhilCook.com. And I encourage you to go check out his stuff. Go check out his YouTube channel. Watch his stuff. It's really good. I learned from him. I learned from this guy. And I've been following this guy for years. All right. Since 2010. I sat in one of his sessions when they had a Power 21 conference down in Oklahoma. I sat in on one of his sessions. I'm like, this guy is fabulous. He's full of knowledge and stuff. And I just gravitated him ever since. So what's been going on at the home front here? Well, we've just been hanging out, being creative, having some art projects, doing, you know, kind of watching some new shows, of course. I just finished up Star Trek Picard, and oh my goodness, highly recommend it. It is so good. It's definitely different from all the other Star Trek series, you know, because it kind of paint the picture of Starfleet being the bad guy after, you know, the whole Star Trek Nemesis movie, which, you know, there's a lot of... I haven't fully watched Nemesis. I probably need to sit down and watch Nemesis after I watched the whole 10 episodes of the season one of Picard. But my goodness, it is so good. And I'm not going to spoil anything for it, but there's a good twist at the end of the season that I didn't see coming. I did not see coming. But I'll just paint it as this. Picard has a brain disease. And I guess it was known before the series, but they really reference it more in this series, and something happens at the end. You just have to watch it. It's really good. You know, yeah, it's sad, but then you're like, oh, he's okay at the end of it all. So, but it's a really good series. He basically gathers all these rogue people. And I love Captain Rios in this series. He's a former pilot of Starfleet. And basically, he gets former people of Starfleet together, and he just goes rogue. And it's so awesome. And there's a whole story about synthetic life forms like Data. They reference Data a lot. They introduce Data's daughters, which one of them dies in the first episode. And then there's a twin out there that he's trying to rescue and figure out. And I guess there's a plot with the Romulans where they had a prophecy where the synthetic life forms were going to destroy the universe. Which almost happens. It almost happens. But you just have to watch and check it out. And but man, you know, you got Seven of Nine from Voyager in there, you know, back in action. You got the Borg cube out there, which is called the Artifact. And basically, it's a reclamation project headed by none other than the former Borg Hugh, all right, from Next Generation. And he's the director of it. But, you know, things go crazy wrong and, you know, things happen. But I'm not going to spoil anything. You have to watch the series. It's really good. And I love every bit of it. And just kind of really... The focal point is on Picard, and they do flashback to the past here and there on some things, you know, that takes place. And what's great about this series, it takes place right after, you know, the supernova that destroys Romulus, which Star Trek 2009 movie, you know, talks about, and basically just resets the timeline from that point on. Well, basically, it's an alternate timeline it creates. But this is afterwards. They're painting this picture after the supernova destroying Romulus, and then, you know, the whole rescue of the Romulans, and which Picard basically, this is his final act in Starfleet until he decides to walk away from it all. But yeah, it's a very good series, and you should check it out, you know, if you're a Star Trek fan. And it's really good. I highly recommend the series. And again, I finished it. I want more. I want more episodes of Star Trek Picard. It's so good. You should check it out. Well, that's it for this week's episode. But thank you guys for watching, to kind of give you a little bit of updates on what's going on with the church, what we got happening there. I'll talk about my little quick review of Star Trek Picard. So we'll see you guys next time on The AJ Show. Thank you for watching. Have a great day. Stay safe.